What's that sound? It's been a long time, Mr. Bond, since we've had a Vesper Martini. So, in honor of this fragrance that I'm reviewing, I'm making a Vesper Martini. And here it is in the beautiful golden color. Vodka, gin, and a little bit of quina lillet, or it's called lillet now. And stick this over here. And a lemon peel that goes around the edge, but I'm out of lemon peel, so I'm using a mandarin peel in my cocktail. So let's get on with the show. Cheers.
Just a silly phase I'm going through, and just because I call you up, don't get me wrong, don't think you got it made. I'm not in love, no, no. Upon the wall,
So, it has been a very, very long time since I've made any videos in regards to fragrance reviews, but I came across this fragrance. I don't know how I missed it. Number 007 by Floris. And I am a huge James Bond fan, especially the Daniel Craig series of films in the franchise. Of course, you know, I remember seeing Dr. No when I was 12 years old. It came out in 1962, and I went to the theater and saw it, and that was my introduction to James Bond. And of course, I loved and adored Sean Connery's performance as James Bond. And I also particularly liked Timothy Dalton's rough edge, kind of Daniel Craig-ish portrayal of James Bond. But in any case, being such a fan, I thought I would buy this fragrance when I found out about it this year. And it came out 2 years ago in honor of the 60th anniversary of the release of Dr. No, and to celebrate the entire franchise. And so when I found out about it, I said, how did I miss this? So I bought it. It's a limited edition, and you can still get it on eBay, which is where I got mine. And it comes in this wonderful box. You hear me slapping this little corner here. It comes in this wonderful box, a wonderful packaging, and you open it up, and there it is. Absolutely beautiful. And I'm going to just read to you what it says inside really quickly. Number 007, Eau de Parfum, created in celebration of James Bond film franchise special anniversary, 60 years since the release of Dr. No in 1962. This exclusive fragrance is fondly distilled from 60 incredible years of 007 on the silver screen. Number 007 naturally draws inspiration from the effortless style and substance of the legendary man himself, as well as being developed from carefully gleaning the spectacular cinematic experience of the exotic locations featured in the films. Coupled with the diverse and truly exceptional cultural influence that the Bond films have inspired over the generations, a rich and spicy fragrance with amber at its base, this captivating scent is a blend of refreshing citrus, juniper notes against a subtly smoky accord with flashes of spicy dianthus, carnation, and an aromatic heart created by the fusion of rose, lavender, rosemary, and geranium, underscored by the reassuring warmth and sensual ambers, sandalwood, oak moss, and musk. So it also comes with this wonderful little booklet right here. Just incredible little booklet that tells you all about the history of the beginning of the James Bond franchise. There's Sean Connery holding up a clapperboard for 007's first outing as Dr. No. And here he is making a cocktail. And there he is wearing the famous red carnation, which they have referenced in the fragrance. They reference many things in this wonderful fragrance from James Bond. And then they have a whole list of all of the posters for all of the films. So what do I think of this fragrance? Of course, the bottle is absolutely gorgeous. The traditional Floris bottle, as always, with the royal warrants at the side there. I'm wearing it, but I'm going to spray fresh out of the bottle right there to get those wonderful top notes. So right off the bat, I'm getting the Caribbean because of its similarity in the opening to a beautiful bay rum. It really is just indicative of that wonderful fragrance that is so connected to the Caribbean and to Jamaica. And I just love the opening. There's also a touch of juniper, which references the martini, which is a great touch. And also in the mid notes, there is this beautiful rose, which is an homage to England, because England is famous for its beautiful roses. It has a sophistication, but also a sharp, dangerous edge, which is just perfect for that blend in James Bond of sophistication and always a hint of danger lurking in and around him. Better put this down, I'm enjoying it too much. And in the bass, in the dry down, there's this beautiful sandalwood, which references India, and oak moss, which I get a feeling that reminds me of James Bond's roots in Scotland. And the amber in the dry down is just beautiful. It's so beautifully crafted, so thoughtful in the way it was created. And I think this is going to be, not because I'm such a fan of James Bond and Ian Fleming and all of that, and Floris. Of course, Floris was Ian Fleming's favorite fragrance house, and he always wore number 89. But not because of that, but because it really is a beautiful, beautiful fragrance on its own, connected or not connected with James Bond. So I'm just very thankful that Eon Productions hooked up with Floris to create this incredible fragrance. And you can still find it. It's really, I think, worth that bit of extra money that you have to spend for it. But it's definitely something I'm going to be wearing for a long, long time. So this is Lanier Smith from Sense Memory saying, remember, wear what you love and not what they say you should like. Cheers. Before I wrap this up, I would really be curious to see who your favorite Bond is and which your favorite Bond film. So let me know in the comments below. Cheers.